Silence by Edgar Allan Poe by Anita Hibbard, March 1st, 2023. There are some qualities, some incorporate things that have a double life, which thus is made a type of that twin entity which springs from matter and light, evinced in solid and shade. There is a twofold silence, sea and shore, body and soul. One dwells in lonely places, newly with grass o'ergrown, some solemn graces, some human memories and tearful lore render him terrorless, his name's no more. He is the corporate silence, dread him not. No power hath he of evil in himself, but should some urgent fate, untimely lot, bring thee to meet his shadow, nameless elf, that haunteth the lone regions where hath trod no foot of man, commend thyself to God. 1840. End of poem. This recording is in the public domain.
Silence by Edgar Allan Poe by Anthony Smitha. There are some qualities, some incorporate things that have a double life, which thus is made a type of that twin entity which springs from matter and light, evinced in solid and shade. There is a twofold silence, sea and shore, body and soul. One dwells in lonely places, newly with grass o'ergrown. Some solemn graces, some human memories and tearful lore render him terrorless. His name's no more. He is the corporate silence. Dread him not. No power hath he of evil in himself, but should some urgent fate, untimely lot, bring thee to meet his shadow, nameless elf, that haunteth the lone regions where hath trod no foot of man, commend thyself to God. 1840. End of poem. This recording is in the public domain.
Silence by Edgar Allan Poe by Bruce Kachuk. There are some qualities, some incorporate things that have a double life, which thus is made a type of that twin entity which springs from matter and light, evinced in solid and shade. There is a twofold silence, sea and shore, body and soul. One dwells in lonely places, newly with grass o'ergrown. Some solemn graces, some human memories and tearful lore render him terrorless. His name's no more. He is the corporate silence. Dread him not. No power hath he of evil in himself. But should some urgent fate, untimely lot, bring thee to meet his shadow, nameless elf, that haunteth the lone regions where hath trod no foot of man, commend thyself to God. 1840.
End of poem. This recording is in the public domain.
Silence by Edgar Allan Poe by C.J. There are some qualities, some incorporate things, that have a double life, which thus is made a type of that twin entity which springs from matter and light, evinced in solid and shade. There is a twofold silence, sea and shore, body and soul. One dwells in lonely places, newly with grass o'ergrown.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.